This is Pat Cox, welcome back to round two of a Theros draft here on Channel Fireball. I'm not gonna mulligan. I mean, I do have a fair number of expensive cards in my deck that this hand could be good with, but this could really bite me in the ass. I mean, I essentially have six lands. Then, you know, if I start drawing the more expensive guys and get to cast them earlier, that is pretty strong, so. Feel like whenever I make a keep like this, that's what immediately happens is I draw a land and feel stupid. And I already have as many lands as I could reasonably need in the game. That's enough to monstrous my Gorgon. Obviously with like whip I can always use a lot of mana, but all right, well, that's good. Probably does not have a Magma Jetter. We had already used it, but we'll see if we draw out some kind of. Any lightning strikes us for some reason? He chose not to. That was probably the correct thing to do. See what he's got here. All red. Probably has that Fnatic. Mean, it doesn't necessarily mean he's a mono red deck, he's only played mountains, but probably indicates he's reasonably heavy red if he also kept this hand. Sure. I'll take it. Yeah, I regret this keep. Oh well. We have my Boon of Erebos mana. Still haven't quite been bitten in the ass because I've cast something every turn, but next turn when I draw another land, I'm not gonna be too happy. Gonna bemoan my horrible luck from my choosing to keep a dubious hand. All right, what do you got? So can trade one of his guys for one of my guys. I just get to play Fox. That's fine. Also, I don't know that he would even block. I mean, he doesn't have anything up, and I have a number of different green spells I could cast or block spells. Just a number of different spells I could cast here. Also, this is the best thing I could have drawn. So. That's good. This will kill your two-headed guy. Has more potential to be scary. I don't know. I don't know his hand or anything, but blocking there is pretty scary. Like, this gets 2 for 1 very easily. It's not representing anything really. I mean, I guess he's representing giving both guys first strike, but that would have been good there. Though not good enough to get through a +2/+2, so. Well, that's also scary. I'll draw a time defeat, that'd be nice. Nah, that's also fine. He's like obviously gonna block there, but if he like pumps this, it already becomes bigger than the Vulpain guy, so let's take my Savage Surge where I can, I guess. Ask if I could follow up with a guy. He's still probably pretty dead. I mean, I don't think you can both play a guy and pump this turn. But if he doesn't do both, then I get to attack with this, which is all I want out of life right now. Alright, well, that is actually pretty good. Just to kill this. That's, I mean, he has to have a jump blocker, otherwise he wouldn't have made that attack. Okay. Ugh. What? That doesn't even make sense. Why the hell would you not do that first? Yeah, I'm like pretty dead now. Yeah, I mean, if I jump there, well, I guess you can still. Can you still do it? Yeah, it triggers before. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Though he could have just fought and he doesn't know what I have. Could fought and killed me, but right, now do I have anything I can bestow on this that actually kills him? I can deal 5. I think I can deal 6. Okay. We got with deals with stupid centaur guy. Probably not a lot. Another deck where fade might be good to have. Doesn't seem as important as against the last deck. Yeah, we'll stay as is, I think.